steamer began to move slowly away. But on the landward horizon appeared the silhouette of a fighting machine. Another came, and another, striding over hills and trees, plunging far out to sea and blocking the exit of the steamer. Between them lay the silent, grey, ironclad Thunder Child. Slowly it moved toward shore, then with a deafening roar and whoosh of spray, it swung about and drove at full speed towards the waiting Martians.
There were ships of shapes and sizes scattered out along the bay, and I thought I heard her calling as the steamer pulled away. The invaders must have seen them as across the coast they filed, standing from between them. There lay Thunderchild. Through the waters, cannons blazing as she came, brought a mighty metal warlord crashing down in sheets of flame. Sensing victory was nearing, thinking fortune must have smiled, people started cheering. Come on, Thunderchild, come on, Thunderchild.
Martians released their black smoke, but the ship sped on, cutting down one of the tripod figures. Instantly, the others raised their heat rays and melted the Thunder Child's valiant heart. Smoke cleared, the little steamer had reached the misty horizon and Carrie was safe. But the Thunder Child had vanished forever, taking with her man's last hope of victory. The leaden sky was lit by green flashes, cylinder following cylinder, and no one and nothing was left now to fight them. The Earth belonged to the Martians.